Okay guys, welcome to the F1 2016 career mode. Sorry the video is so short and this is a voiceover that I'm doing just for this part of the video. I was going to have qualifying in, but the file that I recorded for qualifying got corrupt, so I will hand you over to the commentators now, and then you'll be in the safe hands for the Grand Prix of me. So hopefully you'll enjoy this British Grand Prix. I know I have, and I know I did enjoy it, so hope you guys will as well. So I will see you guys in Hungary for the next race afterwards, so enjoy today's Grand Prix.
His winning total at the season's end, just 30 points. My, how times have changed. So let's see who can reach the top step of the modern podium today. Straddling the border of Northamptonshire and Buckinghamshire, the 18 corners of the Silverstone circuit form the 3.6-mile beating heart of Formula One. It's been reinvented over the years, with Turn 1 now the fast right-hander of Abbey, along with two DRS zones on the Wellington and Hanger Straits, respectively. But the magic of racing is as strong here as it's ever been. With me today is a man who's no stranger to the thrills of Silverstone. He's a past winner here, in sports cars, of course. It's our good friend, Anthony Davidson. You seem particularly excited for this one, Ant. Is there something you want to tell me?
Oh, just looking forward to it, Crofty. It's always a very special atmosphere, and also I started karting in the late 1980s and I was here for that epic race in 1986 with Mansell and Piquet fighting each other right here in my home Grand Prix. So coming back to Silverstone always means a lot, and looking at the crowd today, it's clear that none of that spirit has been lost. And also, we just have such a fantastic field this year, some very close competition and conditions that should make for some great racing. I can't wait.
Okay, I know it's your home Grand Prix, but treat it like any other race. Don't take unnecessary risks.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position. And Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Ricciardo, Rosberg, Sebastian Vettel, and Raikkonen, Bottas, Alonso, Button, and Carlos Sainz, Sauber, Massa, Sergio Perez, and Kvyat, Wehrlein, Nasser, Nico Hülkenberg, and Esteban Gutierrez, Grosjean, and Palmer, Kevin Magnussen, and Rio Haryanto completes the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Okay, the lights are coming on for the start of the British Grand Prix. Can we get some points again like we did in Austria? The lights are out and we are underway. We get off to an okay start. Massa should have got a better start on the inside there, which he did, yes. We're around the outside of a Ferrari and a Toro Rosso. We've made contact with them. And, there's Lewis Hamilton spinning. Whoa, whoa. Hamilton spinning and hit Kimi Raikkonen. We'll take a look at the replay of that start while we try to settle down. Virtual safety car, we'll take a look at that start. Okay, guys, this is a look at what happened at the start of the Grand Prix. As you can see, we got off to a decent start here. We got Wehrlein trying to split the middle. We're going around the outside of a Ferrari and a Toro Rosso. We pinched him and made contact with him. There's Lewis going off. We don't know what happened with him, but we will see in a moment. Okay, guys, so this is on board with Lewis Hamilton of what happened in that race start. He seemed to get off to a good start. He had a Ferrari to his two Red Bulls to his outside. They made contact. Ricciardo and Hamilton made contact. He got hit by Bottas, and that's why he was, you know, spinning round in circles. So yeah, let's get back to the action of the Grand Prix. That start there, I don't know what happened there with the other drivers and that, but I don't know what happened with Lewis. I probably have shown you what happened in, you know, on board with Lewis up front or with Verstappen, but yeah, he was spinning when we came onto the scene, but yeah, it's not been a good start for one of the home favourites, and we're in 8th position. 13 laps today at Silverstone. We're supposed to schedule to pit between 5 and 8 when this virtual safety car goes. Well, VSC is ending right now, just as I said it. There we go, we're back to racing speed here at Silverstone. Through the Maggots and Becketts complex for the first time when you go off the circuit a little, that's my apologies. But at least it's dry for this race, unlike in qualifying, but I don't... Oh, Massa's got past Hamilton immediately. I did not expect that to happen. Okay, so Lewis must be carrying some residual damage from that accident with Kimi Raikkonen. Nobody's out of the Grand Prix yet, but I think Lewis is in problems. He's 23 points behind Sebastian Vettel in the championship, but as Verstappen leads the first lap of the Grand Prix, what are we going to do? We come across the line. It's not going to be that quick, but yeah, Lewis is heading off to the pits, so there's another incident. Daniel Ricciardo is out of the Grand Prix. I don't know what happened there. We'll probably check in a replay any moment now. And this, guys, is what happened to Daniel Ricciardo. As you can see, when we went back to racing on lap two, he made a fantastic move at turn one up the inside of his teammate, of Max Verstappen. And then coming round this next sector, he just sort of stopped. And that's not a very good camera game for that, but I can tell you certainly what happened. I will rewind it here. He came through into turn one, past his teammate, and then the Red Bull Renault, Tag Heuer sponsored Red Bull Renault, gave up on him in the first few laps of the Grand Prix. So, disappointment for Ricciardo. Back to the action. So then, this Grand Prix, we've already had a car casualty, which is Daniel Ricciardo, which puts us up to P7, which means we might be in the hunt for some very good points here today. We didn't know if we were going to get points in Austria, and we ended up coming with a P4. But we get a good run out of that corner, which is good. The Sauber is good. We just need a little bit more power. Just a little bit more power, and I would be happy with this car. Next few laps, was it dry for Q3 then? I don't really know, but yeah, we just need to settle into a rhythm. Everybody's going purple on this lap because it's the second lap of the race, the first lap at full racing speed without any virtual safety cars, but we get sideways through there. Massa's definitely going to be on a charge. There's Rosberg setting the fastest lap of the Grand Prix, and he leads the Grand Prix. Nico Rosberg leads the British Grand Prix. Okay, entering lap 3 now. DRS has been enabled, and we've done a 36. Did Nico do a 21? No. If he did, this game's kind of glitched and broken at the minute. But yeah, we've done a 36.8 for our fastest lap. That's not going to be challenging the Mercedes or anything, so it's lap 3 of the British Grand Prix. We're doing well in 7th, considering we did well to avoid that incident with Lewis and Raikkonen. And then, I don't know what happened with Ricciardo at this moment, but you guys will know, because this is a live commentary, of course, so you guys will know at the end. Okay, so we don't seem to be losing too much pace over Felipe Massa, but we don't seem to be pulling away, so if we can settle down into this rhythm, Silverstone is a good track for me, which means only one thing: we could be on for a good finish here. Some points definitely on the table here, so yeah, we just need to keep it calm, keep it settled, you know, pick as overtaking maneuvers when we can get them. I would like to keep to the current plan. As Button takes the fastest lap, now it's Vettel, and Verstappen leads the Grand Prix again. The lead is changing hands all over the place. Up front, and of course it'd be up front, but yeah, I don't know. I don't know when I will win a Grand Prix. I don't think it's going to be in season one. But as I want to drive for Williams as well, you know, for season two, fighting with their cars might be the way to do it, to prove you can race against their cars or race good with their cars. Look, there's Felipe Massa. He's on his way. I don't know if we'll be able to hold off the Brazilian. Hamilton sets the fastest lap of the Grand Prix, should I say. Congratulations to Lewis on lap 4. Yeah, if the situation changes, please let me know, because I don't want to be stuck out on dry tyres in the rain. Okay, so We've got Felipe Massa, former Sauber driver himself, chasing us down in the Williams. We look to go from Sauber to Williams, but not to end our career like Massa almost did. But yeah, I would love to drive that Williams in this career season. Well, in, you know, over these career seasons, should I say. There's 10 of them. Okay, 8 tenths behind us. Felipe Massa, you're going to be in DRS range. Stay out, James, this time. Stay out, and we should be comfortably ahead of Massa. I don't think we're really fighting the Williams, but I'm gonna fight him. There's no need for me to not to, so. Felipe Nasr's in the pits, as run wide. Massa's coming up the inside. Down into the first turn. Brilliant move by the Brazilian as we cut back to the outside. The inside for the next corner. Can we get him into this hard braking zone? Yes, we can. We pass Felipe Massa. We take back our seventh position. We're saying to Felipe Massa, if you're going to want this position, you're going to have to fight a lot harder than that. We're not going away easy in this Grand Prix, Felipe. As much as I love you, man, I'm still not letting you go, so. Okay, now the tyres have worn out, which means less grip. Well, they're not worn out, but they're not. They've gone way past their best. Let's have a look at them. They've gone more past their best. Way past their best. It's. Wow. That's why Felipe was able to catch us so quick. As we run wide at cops, don't want to do that too many times. Track limits. Okay, breaking down into the Maggots and Beckett's complex as we're on the grass again. Okay, we've got Felipe Massa right there again. He's going to have DRS pitting. Yes, I'm going to give you the outside, Felipe. He should have DRS, but he's not quick enough in a straight line without the slipstream. Are you going to follow us in, Felipe? He certainly is. Felipe Massa's going to be following us in. We need to break for the line. 37 mile an hour. There we go. Spot on. Spot on. Our braking zone was our line there. So Perez goes by. We've got Massa behind us. I don't know if we're going to be held up by anyone in the pit lane. Massa drives into his pit box. We drive into ours. We get the medium tyres. We have to wait for these cars going. Go. Get out ahead of Felipe. Yes. We're out ahead of Felipe. That's good. It's good news. It's good news, that is. Come on. As Hamilton goes by on the soft tyres, he's yet to pit, I believe. Oh, wait. No, he has pitted once, so. Okay, we're out ahead of our teammate Felipe Nasr, who has jumped Felipe Massa in the stops. Which is, well, Nasr, what are you doing on the soft tyre, Felipe? Well, you couldn't have made it to the end on the mediums from where you pitted, but still. I hope the team don't want Midges to move over and let Felipe through because he's on a different strategy, because that is not going to happen. It'd be like Monaco in the real life 2016 season if they asked me to move over for my team. No, I'm kidding. I'm a team player. Okay, so. Now we're on fresh tyres. Let's see what we can do. Vettel leads the Grand Prix, but I think that's during everybody else's pit stop. Through cops, we're fine through there now. Our teammate, of course, will be on the quicker tyre. But we've got 24 more championship points than you, I think. Or, no, I don't think we've got that many more, but as we mess up that final sector through Maggots and Beckett's. As he's closing in on us, he will have DRS, but I don't know if he's going to be able to do anything with it, is he, Felipe? As we run very wide there, I'm not very. Yeah. I'm having a few problems, just because it's been a while since I played this game, so you have to bear with me. The racecraft will definitely improve over the next few videos, and we've got some cars. What are you doing, Felipe? No, what are you doing? You've just cost me a. Oh no, never mind, we're in the points. But you've got Felipe Massa right behind us, and we dive up the inside of a teammate again. That's how to race side by side as teammates. Okay, so we will have DRS. The only driver that won't will be Felipe Nasr, and he's in this group, and There's Felipe Massa. Go defensive because I didn't change gear. I was focusing too much on the cars behind. Heavy on the brakes down into this what used to be the final corner. We get a good run off ahead of Felipe Massa, so we're in P9. That's not bad. There's Felipe coming for another charge at Cops. He's not been able to do it. We're holding him around the outside. He backed out of the move. I'm pretty sure, Felipe, if you wouldn't have backed out of that, you would have had it. But we've had a mistake, a little mistake coming through this next sector. Okay, so now we're going to have DRS on. He's going to have DRS on us. So is Felipe Nasi. He goes to the inside. We're getting swamped by cars all over. There's Sergio Perez. No, Nico Hülkenberg's crashed us out of the British Grand Prix. What the hell was that, Felipe? Not Felipe, Nico Hülkenberg. Let's have a look at that as we all come blasting down. I went to defend my teammate. We made a little bit of contact. But then I gave him enough room, I believe. And then we spammed straight off into the barrier and out of the British Grand Prix. Because of Nico Hülkenberg, we are out of the British Grand Prix. As you can see, I probably squeezed him out a little, but he should have known there was not enough room there. Because look at my wheel. I went that way and then I went turning that other way. Yep, it was definitely Nico Hülkenberg's fault, that was, I believe. As we came into contact down here at one of the fastest parts of the track, not if the fastest. Look at the Sauber. Oh, sorry, yeah, look at the Sauber bouncing all over the place and off into the barrier to finish this Grand Prix, the British Grand Prix. That's terminal damage. Not the first race we've been out. We've been beaten by his rival today because we've been crashed out of the British Grand Prix by Nico Hülkenberg. And it looks like Ferrari wins yet again here today here in Formula One. I cannot believe that good drive though, good drive for Kimi Raikkonen, for Sebastian Vettel on winning the British Grand Prix, but I cannot believe that happened with Hülkenberg. I cannot believe that. I could have scored some points, had a decent finish, but there he is. Without Lewis Hamilton on the podium, it was Vettel, Rosberg, and Max Verstappen, who qualified on pole position, of course. Congratulations to Sebastian Vettel as they spray the champagne. The Formula One British Grand Prix has been won by Ferrari and by Sebastian Vettel. Our Grand Prix was cut short thanks to Nico Hülkenberg in the Force India. I don't know what to say about that, but yeah. Button finished P4. Wow. Can you believe it? And our teammate finished in 20th as well, so Rio Haryanto, okay, so yes, guys, so I will see you at the championship standings and back at the menu, of course, you know, to check out how we're doing with his rivals and stuff. We probably lost this rivalry, but yeah, we'll see you then. Okay, so here's the driver's standings. We have 22 points now in the championship, but we've moved down to 12th in the driver's standings. Our teammate still has 1 point. Haryanto is yet to score here today, this season. But Sebastian Vettel increases his lead over the two Mercedes boys, who have been swapped positions now thanks to Lewis only getting a couple points today. So 30 points the gap is at the top. We're still in 8th position in this constructors. Toro Rosso's sort of edging away, but Ferrari is still in the lead with 15 points. So this championship, I don't know how to explain what's going off in this season. Nico Hülkenberg took us out. I would have restarted the race if it was early in the Grand Prix, but I chose not to. So here's our resource points. Clean lap, 53%. Yep. We just went over half a distance, didn't we? So, 807 resource points. Our rival did beat us. We have been beaten by Pascal Wehrlein. Yeah, we failed basically everything. So, yeah, we just overachieving, but not by much. My career score, never mind about that. Let's go to the laptop and see where the next Grand Prix is. It's going to be in Hungary. And do we have any resource things that we can do? Anything power-wise? No, we can't. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you've liked it, hit that like button down below. I'm not angry about that. With Nico Hülkenberg, he's got less points than us in the championship, and I don't know. We'll move on to the next Grand Prix in Hungary, guys. Hopefully, we can have a better finish there. I don't really know what else to say. A better finish in Hungary, let's hope so. And I will see you there.